Hey, good afternoon, everybody. Mark again here, Weatherman Plus. I'm going to give you the latest update on what is going on with PTC 9. It will become Tropical Storm Hurricane Helene. So right now, they're looking like it's going to be towards King Tide, and it's going to add an extra foot towards your storm surge. They are comparing this towards Idalia, Dennis, of course, Michael, and Ian as well. And the system is going to be bigger and broader. A bigger, broader system is going to bring a wider area of intense storm surge as well as the winds. And that big wind field is where you're going to get a lot of your power outages also. Also, don't shelter in place for the high rises. Right close to the bend area is where there's a lot of high rises over there. And you might think you're okay in a high rise, but if the winds are Cat 3 winds on the ground level, it's a lot stronger way up there where you're at. So you'd be even worse impact. So do not shelter in place at a high rise. Also, not looking like the shear is going to do too much. Matter of fact, the trough that we're going into is going to help this system breathe better, and it will help it intensify. Now, so far, they have it around 110 miles per hour sustained winds, but look how far it still is all the way until landfall. This is where it intensifies and gets stronger and stronger. Matter of fact, we're seeing more intensification from the models, getting all the way down to 900 millibars. Matter of fact, they just upgraded it again, guys. This is going all the way towards 115 now. Officially, will be a major hurricane by Thursday, 1 p.m., and you still got more time. This could be a weakening trend right here, or this could be a strengthening trend. We still don't know, but he still have the center going towards Tallahassee. But please don't concentrate on the cone. This is going to be some serious impacts on the cone. This system is going to be big and broad. It's going to be a big area of storm surge, a big wind field, creating a lot of power outages as well. Now, Governor DeSantis has put out a state of emergency for 41 Florida counties already. Latest intensity guidance keeps going up and up. It's going all the way towards a Cat 5 on a couple of the models now, and they're starting to trend more and more on that Cat 2, Cat 3 for sure. So definitely a major hurricane is what you're looking at. How much of a major hurricane is the question. Also showing that it will go down immediately towards a tropical storm. So landfall could be sometimes within 72 hours. For another 12 hours after that, you're still looking at hurricane force winds while it's going towards Florida Panhandle as it goes through potentially Georgia, maybe even the Carolinas or Tennessee. Still looking at tropical storm force winds. Some models showing it's still going to become a hurricane. And maybe the wind gusts of at least 50 or 60 miles per hour wind gusts will still reach up towards Indiana, maybe even Illinois or Ohio. Now, this system is forecasted to strengthen up right in the far western Caribbean Sea, showing it will be near hurricane strength, if not already a hurricane. That's why they have hurricane watches out as well for the Yucatan and for Cuba. And you have tropical storm warnings out also. The National Hurricane Center also said that they are expecting the system to intensify while it moves northward over the eastern Gulf of Mexico. And it could be a major hurricane when it reaches the northeastern Gulf Coast on Thursday. Now, once again, don't forget, we have a lot of warm temperatures in the Gulf of Mexico. Matter of fact, well above average, all the way to the current loop over here and right off the coast of Florida. And that is right where we have all that deep ocean heat content. And once again, you see it is grown on the latest update, showing right by that current loop is really warm. Now, the latest deterministic run with GFS does take it a little bit further of a curve. You see it's almost a 50-50. It all depends which one wins out, whether that trough is stronger or whether that high pressure is stronger, whichever one will take over. So far, it's looking like the trough is going to be stronger. It's going to be more of a northward push. Now, even though the purple right here, your deterministic, shows the latest run, if you look at this black right here, this is actually your average, and your control member is also that line with the blue, showing it still will go somewhat towards Tallahassee. Now, when you look with the Euro, you can see the same thing, showing still right towards Tallahassee. And when you look with the Canadian, you can see the same thing, right towards Tallahassee. Now, the latest automatic tropical cyclone forecast is a little bit spread out. If it goes a little further to the north over here in the western Caribbean, it could take a little more of that westward track. But still, they have a lot of confidence that it will start pushing to the west and then come back. A little east of Tallahassee is the latest on this one. You also have to watch out for this. When you look at your jet stream, you can see as you're starting to get your trough, you start to get your system forming up. And instead of putting shear on your system, it actually helps it breathe. It helps your system's outflow. You see all the outflow coming out from this storm? It catches right with the jet stream going very fast. So it's helping that outflow get away so it can keep breathing and intensifying. This will help that storm intensify because of the jet stream is going to help the outflow breathe better. Now, the latest run with GFS does take that curve, but like I just explained to you, it will switch around a little bit. That part is still not known yet. But it does take it where it's still a major hurricane. A Cat 4 starts somewhere around 944 millibars. Still takes it very strong. A little bit of weakness on the GFS. Latest on Hurricane Analysis Forecast System A takes it down to a Cat 5. It is one that takes it down to a Cat 5, 900 millibars. I believe it's 922 or 920 millibars, brings it down to a Cat 5. Showing that it will bring winds somewhere around 156 miles per hour sustained winds. And as it gets closer towards landfall, it will weaken down a little bit if that's what you want to call weak. 151 miles per hour sustained winds as that comes onshore and stays strong. It's still 50, 60 miles per hour sustained winds as it goes up Georgia and starting off in the 70s. Wind gusts. Still very powerful, over 170 miles per hour, 180 miles per hour wind gusts. Remember, you will start feeling the winds on western Florida. If this wobbles further to the east, this will be more intense impacts on the western Florida. Remember that. As it goes closer, it goes down to 177 miles per hour. And that is wind gusts picking up very strong. Look at the wide area it is covering with all of these winds. Not only the 100, but you got the 60s, you got the 50s spread way out. And as it goes further upland, it's still over 80 miles per hour wind gusts, over 100, over 90, still staying strong all through Tennessee, the Carolinas, Kentucky, Virginia. Still got 60, 70, even 80 miles per hour wind gusts. Just rolling around. Still 50s going towards Indiana and 60s. So it's still going to stay strong all the way northern. Hurricane Analysis Forecast System B takes it down to 902. Weakens down a little bit before landfall. That's what you want to call weak. Still a Cat 5 hurricane. When you look at H-Wharf, it shows again another very strong Cat 4 hurricane. It's right on the edge of a Cat 5. You literally might call that a Cat 5. It's right on the low grade of it. Still very intense. Seeing a little bit of curve in each one of these. And you can see on the H-Mon, another hurricane model, takes it down to a 930 millibars. 928 is still a strong Cat 4 hurricane, and it stays strong on land. Stays a hurricane all the way towards the Carolinas, maybe even towards Tennessee. Now you can see when we look at our lower level winds, 850 millibars, how GFS gets really close towards Tampa, bringing chances to bring the storm surge. If it's a little more on the eastern side and northern, look how it brings storm surge in a different direction. Now it brings storm surge into this direction, into Tampa. So I have a map and link in the description for you to see what your worst case scenario would be if you were to get just unbelievable amount of storm surge, just so you know how bad of an area you could possibly be living in. As it goes to southern Georgia, you can see where you're getting that flow of the winds from the Gulf of Mexico. This is going to create storm surge that's going to continue after the storm is gone, still bring it around towards the Carolinas and towards Georgia as it passes by. Now remember, this is your lower level winds. All these strong winds above, this is a good chance for you to get tornadoes right along Florida, all along southern Georgia, and going into South Carolina as well on this run. And this curve more to the west, it could be more to the west. I will keep you updated. This map is by National Hurricane Center because since they don't have a storm surge map just yet, they'll probably have one out for tomorrow. Link is in the description. You zoom in. Once you get to that red, that is above 9 feet. The orange is 6. The yellow is 3. The blue is 1. This lets you know if you're in a flood-prone storm surge area. Now you can see, take this, go to your area and see which place you live at and see what your worst case potential is. Once again, this is not a forecast. This is to show you the weakest and worst spots as this storm comes in, where it could potentially be the worst. Now, right now, National Hurricane Center did put out this much rainfall that will affect Cayman Islands as well as Cuba, some of Yucatan also. But you can see for the Cayman Islands, getting anywhere from 10 inches plus, you're getting somewhere around that 6 to 8, but it could be some 10 inches plus in there. And for Western Cuba as well. We don't have one for the lower 48 yet, but you can see right here on the next 7 days of Weather Prediction Center, bringing a lot inland. All that orange is 5 to 7 inches for Florida, Georgia, Alabama. Look at northern Arkansas, southern Missouri. This thing is going to swirl around for a few days. There's going to be a lot more rainfall for this. But just for the next 7 days, look at all this 5 to 7. Covers northern Florida, Georgia, upstate South Carolina, North Carolina, Virginia, Tennessee. All this brown in the higher elevations of North Carolina and northern Georgia and some of South Carolina as well. All that brown is going from 7 inches plus. Now the banding can start reaching as early as tomorrow night, hitting on Florida. I'm gonna wait till we get a little bit closer for tomorrow so we can see where this track is headed, if it's headed further east or further west, because that's going to dramatically change the impacts as well. Thank you for your time, everybody. Hope you have a very great day today. Thank you so much for all the nice comments this morning. I'm sorry I wasn't able to hold myself together. It was just the worst news you ever want to just tell your best friend. It's just really awful, and it's still bad, but somehow I'm able to still get through it. So God bless all of you. Keep every single one of you safe. You, your neighbors, your friends, your enemies, every single one that you know. Now, before I go for this evening, Isaiah 41, 9 and 10. Thou whom I have taken from the ends of the earth, and called thee from the chief men thereof, and said unto thee, Thou art my servant. I have chosen thee, and not cast thee away. Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee. Yes, I will help thee. Yes, I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. Amen. Have a good night, everybody. I'm going to get more information for everyone for tomorrow morning. I'm going to have information for Georgia, for Alabama, potentially Tennessee and the Carolinas. I'm going to find all the information I can find for all of you to help you prepare the best way you can so you know which direction to go when you do evacuate, and you should be evacuating on this system. Please check on your neighbors. Please check on the pets. Do not leave the pets. I will find pet-friendly shelters for all of you. I will have links for that for tomorrow. Remember, all glory goes to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And he could easily chop off this storm that we've seen him do multiple times in the past. Francine, Beryl, both of those each got chopped. If you can remember, Dreyer got in there and took a big chunk out of it. That's what I'm praying on. Please, Father, intervene on this storm, because nobody wants this storm, not even our enemies, Father. Please help everyone. All glory goes to God forever and ever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Father, for your help. We know you will answer quickly.